All right, ladies and gentlemen, this next section is going to be how to hear music or understanding music. This is a big mystery for a lot of people. A lot of people think that they have to be born with the rhythm to dance well. And that's not true at all. If I could learn to dance, you could learn to dance. To hear music, you are not born hearing music. It's something that is taught to you. Yes, some people generally can hear an inherent louder or more accented beat in the music. But if I said, excellent, do you hear the rumba beat in that song? They would have no clue what I'm talking about. Or do you hear the cha-cha rhythm in that song? Absolutely no clue what I'm talking about. So it has to be taught to even those people. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna teach you how to hear music. And I will even demonstrate and put on one in a few seconds. The first thing that you need to know is that all music, with the exception of a few different songs or a few different types of music, will be written in something where it's called 4/4 timing. You at home don't have to know what that means. That's good for a musician. What you do need to know is that, I'm sure everyone has heard of a bar or a measure of music. Someone has probably heard of that. What that means, and everyone's probably seen a music chart that musicians go by. A lot of you don't know what they're looking at, but you see a whole bunch of lines going like this. All right, again, you don't need to concern yourself with that. What I want you to know is that there would be 4 beats in each one of these sections or measures. You would hear a consistent 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. All right, if you notice, I was accenting the first one, going da, 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 da. All right, what I was doing is clapping out 4 beats or making 4 sounds consistently. How do you know where to start counting from? Whenever you hear people counting music, going 1, 2, 1, 2, or whatever it is that they're doing, if they're dancing with a partner, in this case, we're gonna say 1, 2, 3, 4. How they know where to start counting from is the most accented or the most pronounced beat will be the first beat. That's how you know where to start counting from. You know where to say 1, 2, 3, 4. In the music we're about to play, it's gonna have 4 beats also. Most of the music, popular music, stuff that you hear out when you go out dancing, it doesn't matter to a Latin club, to a club where you need a partner, a club where you don't have a partner or you don't dance with a partner, stuff where you're just freestyling by yourself, will also have music just like this. So whether it's specifically written for partner dancing, whether it's specifically written for a competition that you would see on television or something you'd hear in the elevator, most of it, I would say a good 95% of it, will be written where it has these 4 beats. I'm gonna put on something in a second that we would consider a cha-cha to most of us in the ballroom and Latin dance industry. However, we're gonna use it just for the 4 beats, because they're pretty accented. You should be able to have no problem hearing each one of those 4 beats. And also, it's a decent song. So, let's do this. Again, for those of you at home, 4 beats at a time, and throughout the whole song, it will not change speed, meaning it will not do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it won't slow down. So it won't change speed of any type. So we need to know that. The other thing is all music, or most music, has an introduction. Could be 4 beats, 8 beats, or sorry, could be 4 measures, 2 measures. We don't care about that. Just in the beginning, you'll hear some type of instrumental, maybe someone singing. You won't start counting these numbers until you hear a consistent 1, 2, 3, 4, some type of percussion or some type of something making a strong beat, okay? So for instance, if we could have the music, please. This first song that we're gonna hear, again, we'll have an introduction. So we heard the guitar playing it first, right? And then we heard 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So forget about all the background sounds or background instruments that you hear. Those are not important when you're dancing with a partner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, home to practice counting with me. If you don't count out loud, this is going to be absolutely useless. A lot of people say that they can hear this, but make sure you count it with me. Ready on my mark? 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, count. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, good. We're gonna leave the music on. Let's try this. Let's do another little exercise. Let's put and in between each one of those numbers. Whether this makes sense to you or not, just do it with me. Just so your ear becomes more inclined to hearing and stuff. Okay? We're gonna say 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. On my mark. By the way, we're gonna just pause in the music. There's still a beat in the background. There's still something for you to go by. All right, count the ands with me on my mark. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. All right, when you try this at home, try to notice two things. Are you slowing down or are you speeding up? Generally, we start to get a little overconfident with ourselves. I've noticed this. We'll listen to the music, and the first maybe 3 or 4 measures or sets of counting to 4 will be on time. After that, we think we've got it, and we will start to slow down, or adrenaline takes over when we start to speed up. So this is usually what I notice. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, oh, where did the music go? This happens a lot. You start getting into your head, start listening to other things, to other instruments, or you think you got it, I don't know. But make sure, even while you're dancing, for instance, if I were doing the rumba basic to this, or the cha-cha basic, or whatever it is I'm going to do, I will pay attention to this first and foremost. So, if I were going to do, let's say, my rumba basic, if we could have this song over again, by the way, again, this is a cha-cha. Thank you. By the way, this is a cha-cha, but we're going to use rumba. Why not? We're going to beat borrow. That means we're going to borrow from a different type of music for a different song or a different dance. Here's what I want. We're going to do our box step. Everyone starting with the left foot, starting to the side. We're going to go side together forward, side together back. That's how we're going to start. So whether you're the male or the female, just start off to the left first, okay? Here's the next thing that we're gonna do. We're gonna say 1, 2, 3, hold the 4. 1, 2, 3, hold the 4. 1, 2, 3, hold the 4. 1, 2, 3, hold the 4, okay? All right, let's all try this to my beat. We're on my mark, and we're starting with the left foot, taking the small steps in every direction that we go on my mark. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, hold the 4. 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 Now without me saying hold the 4, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and you know to hold the 4, right? You know it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The 4 is still in there. It hasn't gone anywhere. We're just not counting it because we're not stepping on it. So why would I count, right? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Good. Alright, if you feel you have this, here's what I want you to do. When trying this on your own, let's try starting whenever you feel the music. So what you'll have to do, and what I still have to do, I've been doing this for 15 years, because I still have to count to my head, or in my head, I still have to go one, two, three, four, one, but I'm doing it silently. Good thing is, I know to start to the side on the one. When I was first starting, I would have to do this. I would have to go one, two, three, four, one, two, and I would start late, or I would start early. After a few tries, you will end up getting on time. So, test yourself. Let's go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Make sure your feet are acting like the drumsticks and the floor is like the drum. Make sure you step on the one. Don't step after, don't step before. Even on pauses like that. Ooh, actually that was the ending of the song. Okay, so we're gonna get back to this eventually if we have the music off. We're gonna try this again with a different song. If we could have one moment. This will be an actual rumba, ladies and gentlemen. Pardon me. Okay. This will be a slow rumba because I've slowed it down. This one feels similar to the other one. Feels similar. But you guys hear the Spanish guitar in there. You see how the 1, 2, 3, 4 is not so choppy? Listen to this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whereas the other one, which because it was choppier, it would probably be better to do something like a cha-cha-cha to it. But this is not. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So don't count it like that. And definitely don't dance it like that. All right, everyone say this with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you notice when I was counting, I sounded the exact same, or I tried to sound the exact same each time I was counting. I didn't really change the pitch of my voice, I didn't change the tempo or the speed of my voice, so neither should you, neither can you, okay? All right, let's try our rumba box up to this, and now dance it a little slower and less choppy than how we were dancing the other one, okay? On my mark, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, hold it 4. 1, 2, 3, hold it 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, hold it 4. 1, 2, 3, hold it 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Softer. Notice my movements are not choppy like they were for the other one, because the song is a choppy sound. So why would I try and copy that same feel through my body when the song isn't like that? Perfect example. Again, we had a little pause in the music, but because I didn't slow down or speed up, I was able to be exactly on time to when it picked back up. So all songs, I shouldn't say all songs, but a lot of music will have those little pauses where you won't hear anything, or you won't hear a beat, but yet the song keeps going. Alright, let's try this again, just from a different part, in case you got lost, for those of you who got lost. Remember, 1, 2, 3, hold the 4, that's how we're going to dance it, but very smooth feeling. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And was a slow rubber section. Let's see here. All right, let's try something completely off the wall. We are going to do a salsa. Okay. Same thing. Guess what? There's going to be four beats in here also. Okay? All right. If you do not know how to do the salsa basic, make sure you go to the salsa basic section where I show you how to do the basic of the salsa, whether you're the male or the female. All right, first thing that we need to know is, again, how to hear this. There's those four beats in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4,
at a Brooklyn Track Track, it's also called probably the hardest to hear. Again, because there are four beats in there, but because they're faster, it makes it a lot more difficult to hear. Okay. Let's see if we can find it in this song. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, here's what I'm gonna ask you, something really strange. That box step, guess what? We're gonna do that box step to salsa music, okay? Or this music. So because it's fast, we're gonna have to go really, really slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, again, let's all start with our left foot. We'll go side together forward, side together back, side together forward, side together back. Really small like this. Side together forward, side together back, side together forward, side together back, side together forward, side together back. See how tall I'm going? In order to stay on to the music, I would have to go this small. All right, let's all try it with me. Go on my beat, on my mark. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. From a different angle. Same thing. Just going to my side angle. Starting with my left foot again. 5, 6. 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Again, the four beats are still in there. I'm just not counting the four beats because I'm not doing anything for it. And again, we know that this is politically incorrect to do the box step or do a rumba basic to this type of music. You notice it paused. I just kept going at the same speed, and I was on time when it came back out. We're gonna try this to one more type of song, one more type of song. Anybody guess what type of music this sounds like? Not a waltz. Not a cha-cha-cha, it is a tango. Yes. All right. In here, believe it or not, I can find the four beats in here also. Especially when it starts to get a little louder, but tell me if you can feel this. 1, 2, 3. Let's try our box step, which again, correct, but this is just an exercise for you to be able to hear me, right?
And if you don't hear it, if you don't understand it, I don't care. Go with me, go to my beat. And usually just by doing it, and going to what I'm doing, helps you to understand it. Helps you to be able to do it. And regardless, you'll just start to be able to do it. On my mark. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1,
fancy, just stay on time. That's all I want. Do a good box step. Again. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3. You're only stepping for the first 3 beats of the 4, but not doing anything for the 4th one. If you feel like you got it, try switching. Change your box step up, change facing the directions. Okay, this will be the last song, the last song. This is a merengue. And we can find 4 beats in here also. Even though there's no merengue, no we didn't, but it's, and that's your basic step. All I want is again for you to find the 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, let's try doing our box step again to the 1, 2, 3, 4. Gonna be a little faster again. On my mark, okay? 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2. Oh, we ramped. There we go. Back on. Okay. Good. Let's start over. Now I can start over. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Forget about all the other instruments. The louder I stomp, the easier it is to stay on time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. All right. If you have any questions, or if you want to go to a specific, let me turn this down just a second. If you want to understand how to hear another song or a specific dance, if we actually wanted to hear how to dance to the merengue, go to the merengue section and we'll have some demonstrations on there on how to hear the merengue beat, how to step on the merengue beat along with the other steps. All right, we hope you enjoyed this section of the how to understand listening to music or hearing the rhythm section. Thank you so much.